Hi guys, today I'm gonna solve the problem. As you can see, I'm opening the phone, turning on the phone, and as you can see, the phone is not running Samsung's official software. You may have problems with features or security, and you won't be able to open your phone as it has a custom firmware, that's why, or somehow any other problem. So first of all, I would go to the recovery mode by pressing the power and the volume up button. Okay. It would take some time. Okay. As you can see, it's your phone. Make sure that you have to see this thing. This the A305FDDS4SL1. As you can see, the after S, it's 4. It's the binary version. It's the binary version. You have to care about it. If you just flash a firmware in this phone with a lower binary, you can make this phone. You can make this phone a bit dead. Okay, you can die this phone. That's why you have to flash always a latest binary in the phone. So I have to just keep this phone. Now you have to just go to the repair firmware. As you can see, it's the help tab, and I have. You have to install it from any of the website or of the firmware website. Okay, so as you can see, it's the A305DDS4ASL1. As I have taught you that the binary is really important, so it's the binary 4, and I have showed you that my phone has also this binary. Okay, this F4. So just install it, but I have already installed it. So as you can see, this is the folder named A305DDS4. Okay, so what you have to do is that you have to just open the Audin 3, or before than that, you have to go to the download mode. It won't go by pressing just buttons, so you have to just press the volume down and reboot to bootloader and the power key. When you have entered this mode, as you can see, it's a downloading mode. Okay, now just I have placed it in this position. Now what you have to do is that you have to insert a cable. Sorry, it's okay, you have to insert this cable into the phone. When you have inserted it, now what you have to do is that you have to go into the Audin 3.13.1. It's the latest version, so it's good now. Okay, so as you can see, there's the 0.6. It means that your phone is connected to the computer. Okay, now what you have to do is that you have to put all the files into this thing. So as you can see in the desktop, what I have already downloaded, the A305F binary 4 firmware. So into BL, the BL1, it will take some time. Then in the CP, you can see there's the CP1. Okay, make sure to just attach in the CSC. You should do the home CSC, and in the AP, the AP1. Make sure to do it carefully, as it is a necessary process to flash your phone. iPhone. It would take a minute or two to open the AP file in the Orion 3 because the AP file is the main firmware. It's about 90% of your firmware. That's why it would take too much of your time. Okay. As you can see that all of the firmwares are at their place. So now what you have to do is that you have to just start. You have to just select start. And as you can see, it's done now. It's just flashing its recovery, then the system, and all of them. As you can see, it's now 2 to 3 minutes for the flashing of the phone, but it would take a while because it's the whole processing of the change of firmware into your phone. That's why it would take too much of your time. So wait a little and be patient. So as you can see, it's now 80% and just 20% is left in the flashing of the phone. Sorry for the car.
क्या सीन है क्या ये मतलब आप सोचेंगे और मोड़े
So as you can see, it's now the product and it's all been flashed, just 95% done and 5% left just. So as you can see, it's resetted and passed. Now you will see your phone. As you can see, it's the Samsung Galaxy A30. Okay. It takes some time. It's a normal process. So as you can see,